We're currently experiencing a third digital environment revolution that aims to disrupt the internet's modern barriers and limitations. This phase is known as Web 3.0. But to easily understand what it is, we have to divide internet's growth into three phases: Web 1.0, Web 2.0, and Web 3.0. The first phase is known as Web 1.0, so let's go back to the past, 30 years ago, in the 90s, when the internet was as simple as a MOOC. It was made of several written pages that users could access and just read. Thus, we can immediately identify the greatest lack of the first internet phase, interaction. And just in the early 2000s, we really experienced the greatest internet evolution as a consequence of the interaction's addition to the digital world. Perhaps the greatest example we can make is Facebook, which contributed to decreasing the gap between the digital and the real world. We shared pics, left comments, and chatted with friends, besides making new ones. Social networks began to spread, blogs evolved, podcasts were born, and forums became the next place where to discuss any topic from sports to politics. However, these websites need funds to continue operating, which usually are obtained through advertising material. Third parties need to target potential customers for their product, thus they must know what people may be interested in their goods. To do so, they access users' personal information, which is already collected by websites. This happens in Web 2.0 because users do not have almost any control over their private data. This brings us to the main reason why Web 3.0 is such an important milestone for the digital community. Since users' data is controlled by very few entities, centralization may generate dangerous private issues. Thus, Web 3.0 is being developed with the goal of focusing even more on users and digital interaction by decreasing the level of centralization and moving to a completely decentralized web environment. This is possible through the use of blockchain technology that allows developers to build dApps, where D stands for decentralized. These applications don't have a single entity that manages and safeguards all the operations, but many. And since each one has to make sure that activities on the app are properly working, they have to be incentivized to safeguard the whole network. And here's where cryptocurrency comes in. They are considered a new version of the current financial system, where payments are no longer carried out by banks, but by common people. You'll be the only one responsible for your funds and transactions. However, Web 3.0 is even more than crypto and decentralization. I'm sure that you've already heard about artificial intelligence. Have you ever tried to ask an AI to paint a digital artwork, to suggest you a content strategy or a topic for your next YouTube video? This might have sounded impossible to achieve 10 years ago, but the truth is that artificial intelligence will fastly overcome our daily lives. But Web 3.0 doesn't stop here. The metaverse can be considered the next step of social networks, where instead of sending messages and making calls, we can actually meet other people in a virtual world and start new business activities. Web 3.0 is still under development, and it's hard to predict how things will develop and which ones will succeed. But we can already see that many companies have started to invest in this technology to test its potential. Nobody knows when the transition from Web 2.0 to Web 3.0 will occur, but we can only watch from the outside and see how far things will go.